Hello everyone, welcome back. My name is Bernadette. I'm here to share with you a word of encouragement. I received this word at my point of need, and I hope it's going to encourage also another person. So let's just start off with a word of prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, Amen. Heavenly Father, I come before you this day. I want to say thank you for giving us the gift of life. I want to say thank you for this wonderful day that you've granted unto us. Dear God, as I come in your presence this day, I want to pray, dear God, that whatever word you've given me to share with your children, it will be able to reach the intended people. Dear God, also, as I come in your presence today, I just want it to be more of you and less of me. Dear God, just like John the Baptist says, may you increase and may I decrease. I am just a vessel trying to deliver the word that you've given unto me. I want to pray that it will be more of you and less of me. In the mighty name of God, I pray, trusting and believing. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and Amen. So, like I mentioned, this is a word I received at my point of need. And I'm one person who's been believing for kingdom marriage, a godly marriage, and it's been years since God gave me the promise. And I remember I was just lying in my bed one day and I was just tired of the wait. I was just tired of the process. And I kept on telling God that I am tired. I'm just tired. And the funniest thing is that when I open my YouTube, I just get prophetic messages of kingdom marriages. And I was just lying in my bed telling God, just take away these recommendations of kingdom marriages because I don't want to hear any of them. I just want to focus on some other thing. Let me focus on what you told me to work on, and that thing will just find me in the way. And I remember as I was just lying in my bed, just having like this conversation with God, and God was telling me that, just hold on, it won't be long. And as much as he told me it won't be long, I was just still tired. And I told him, I know it's not going to be long, but I'm just tired. I'm just tired of the wait. I want to be told it's going to be tomorrow, or it's going to be next week, or it's going to be in this specific time, you know. And God was just telling me, focus on God. Focus on me, not the promise, you see. And also, when he gave me that word, it just spoke depth in me because he just reminded me, yes, I've given you a promise, but I don't want you to focus on that promise. I want you to focus on me. Jesus is saying that we should focus on him and not the promises that he's given unto us, because yes, we can be tired and we can be weary, but when we focus on Jesus, when we focus on the cross, our faith will always be renewed. Our strength will always be renewed. So I remember that day, I was still tired. I was still tired. I wasn't hearing any of it as much as he had given me that word. And I went to bed, and actually I was on my bed. So I slept that night and I had this dream that I'm lying in my bed. And then there's two men who are walking one in front of the other, being led by a cat. They walked straight into my bedroom, and immediately I saw them. I sensed this was a negative energy. I sensed this was an evil presence. So I got out of bed and I started praying, casting them off. So when I was praying, there was this, like, it was a wind, a surge of wind that came, and it blew off these two men. And this cat was still very resistant. And I continued to pray and it continued to press on. So it wasn't being cast away. It wasn't moving, but it was still fighting back. So I continued to pray and this cat managed to run and it ran under my bed. So I continued to pray fervently. I continued to pray vigorously, just asking the Lord for help to help me get this cat out of my bed. And nothing was happening. Nothing was moving. It was still under my bed. But I did not give up. I continued to pray. And then there's this man who walked into my bedroom carrying a dead cat. And it was the same cat that had ran under my bed, you know. And I just looked at him and he told me, why are you praying here? And whatever you're praying for has already been captured. Whatever you're praying for has already been killed. It's dead. It's actually here. And he told me, what do you want us to do? What do you want me to do with it? And I told him, just get it out of my house, get it away from any premise near my house. I just want it out of my house forever and for good. And he said that he's going to do exactly that. And then I woke up. So when I woke up, I was just praising God for victory in my dreams. I was just praising God for that deliverance. But then again, I was like, what exactly has been killed? And for cats, or rather in my dream, cat is a symbol of witchcraft. I know there are people who have cats as their pets. That doesn't mean that cats are bad. Cats are good creatures. If you have a pet, you have a cat as a pet, continue keeping your pet, it's okay. But in this particular dream, it's a symbol of witchcraft. So I knew there's a witchcraft attack. There was a witchcraft invasion in my life, or witchcraft attack in my life, which God has already been cleared. That's when I had the victory. That's when the man walked in with a dead cat. But I could not really pinpoint exactly what area in my life has been dead, has been killed, what area in my life has been dead. So I continue to pray and seek the Lord, asking him for answers regarding that particular dream. I'm like, yes, there's victory in this dream, but victory in what area exactly? Victory in my life, yes, but in what area exactly? So I remember it was on a Sunday, and I was just praying and still asking God for more revelation about the dream. And I opened my YouTube, and I remember I saw this wonderful woman of God called Doris. Her channel is called Eldership Ministries. And the title was like, witchcraft on your marriage has been broken. I read that, and it's like my eyes were opened. It was that missing link in my dream. And immediately I knew God was talking about that witchcraft invasion in my marriage. Witchcraft invasion in my marriage has been broken. And I continue to thank God, because now that was that missing link. And going back into my dream, the cat running under my bed, that was my bed symbolized my marriage. So there was that cat that ran under my bed, and it was that invasion of my marriage by this witchcraft activities. And that was what God was telling me, that the witchcraft invasion has already been broken, has already been wiped off. You are free and you are almost there. And before I had that dream is when I was just sitting there having a conversation with God, telling God that I am tired. And God was telling me, just hold on, you're almost there. And just having that dream was a confirmation that I am almost there. And God was just trying to tell me, focus on me, focus on Jesus and not your situation, focus on Jesus and not the promise. Because yes, you will be fatigued, yes, you'll be tired, but when you focus on Jesus, you'll always be renewed. So this is the verse that he gave me, and I've been reading it through. And if you're going through a particular situation or a particular problem, and you feel like, I'm done fighting, I'm done praying, I'm done doing all these things, I'm just done, always meditate upon this. So I'm going to read from Isaiah 40, 29-31, and it reads, he gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. So God is reminding us to turn to him. Turn to him with our problem. Don't focus on your problem. Focus on Jesus. Don't focus on your situation. Focus on Jesus. Don't focus on the promise that he's given you. Focus on the promise giver. Focus on the promise keeper, and you'll be renewed. Your faith will be renewed. Your strength will be renewed, and you'll be able to take one step in front of the other, facing towards your promise, facing towards your God-given promise that God had already shown it to you, God had already given it to you, or God had already said it to you. And also another thing that I'd like to mention is that Whenever you're praying, always pray for all your brothers and sisters who are also in the same situation. If you're someone who's praying for a job or a new job, always try and pray for other people who are in the same situation as you, people who are looking for a job. If you're someone who's praying for a business breakthrough, pray also for other people in the same situation that you're in. And through that, God also will be able to open for you your ways, will be able to open for you your doors. And also through your prayers, you're also helping your brothers and sisters in Christ. Because at the end of the day, we are all one in the body of Christ. So that's it for it from me today. Until we meet again in the next video, it's bye-bye.